Hi, and welcome back to day 5 of the Stowe Sew Along. In our previous video, we assembled the pockets of our bag, and today we'll be sewing up the body and finishing the handles. You're almost done at this point, which is really exciting. I love a good quick project. They're great palette cleansers between larger in-depth projects. But anyway, we are about to watch our stows take shape, so let's dive in. All right, so you're gonna line your bag with your half inch seam allowance, sorry. And I am gonna back tack here. And you're just gonna sew around the bag. We're going to continue down to the bottom. I'm just going to check. Yep, we are at a half inch. So we're going to pivot and continue stitching. Went a little too far. There we go. Clip your threads. All right, so we now have this stitched, so our bag is together. We need to finish the seam allowance, and how you do that is up to you. I don't necessarily recommend sewing this as a French seam because you have 4 layers of fabric here. It's a little bit thick, but if your machine can handle it, you can definitely do that. I'm just going to serge around the edge of mine. So here you can see I have serged the edge of my bag. I used a gray thread so you can see it more easily. And our next step is we're going to head over to our iron and we're just going to press the seam allowance to one side or the other. It doesn't matter which. And we're just going to be doing that from this top edge down maybe an inch or two. So just to the pocket. You don't need to press anything below the pocket. And the reason for this is we're just pressing it so that we can bind the edge. So let's do that now. All right, so here we are at the iron, and I'm going to be doing this over my point press. It's just a little easier. You can do this over the edge of your ironing board. I just can't get down there and still film. So you don't need a point press. It's just a handy little tool that I love. All right, and both sides are now pressed to one side. The next thing we're going to do is cut a piece of your bias binding, approximately 13 inches long for the small bag and 25 inches long for the large bag. You're going to need 2 of these. Now we're going to be binding the edge of this handle. And so the binding is going to need to curve. So I'm going to show you a little tip to make that a bit easier over at the ironing board. So what we're going to do is take our binding and our iron, and we're going to just start gently curving the bias tape so that it already is starting to mimic the curve of the handle. And the reason this works so easily is because it's on the bias, which allows the fabric to stretch. So here now, we head over to the table, you'll see this is pretty much the shape of the handle. So here you can see how we've mimicked that circle. Our next step is to turn our bag right side out. And don't worry about getting the corners perfectly out. We're gonna get to that later. But you just want to see, let me tuck this under, one of the inner handles here. So what we're gonna do is we're going to apply this bias binding to that handle. So starting at one edge, I'm gonna have to turn this so I can get my hands around it. Now you can pin this here, or you can do this at your ironing board. If you're new, I would recommend pinning here. We're just gonna start pinning the bias binding around. And you can stretch this, you'll notice, but you don't want to stretch this because by stretching it, you'll be gathering the handle slightly. You just wanna lay it so the seam line of the bag handle, which is a quarter inch, aligns with the first fold of your double fold bias binding. So just work that around. And pulling the bias binding too tightly is something that a lot of people do when doing their neckline binding, and that often will cause the neckline to not lay flat because the seam allowance is pulled tighter than the area above it. So just keep that in mind. All right, once that's pinned, we're gonna head over to our machine and we're gonna sew right along this first fold at a quarter of an inch, just from here around to here. So let's go do that now. Now for sewing around these tight curves, I like to have the free arm accessible on my machine. So I took the little table off. I just start sewing right at a quarter inch, and I am back tacking, you don't have to. You're just gonna work your way around the handle. Stitching in that first stitch. your threads. Here you can see that first seam. Now we're going to head over to the ironing board. Now what we need to do is we're going to fold the bias binding over to the wrong side. So I'm going to start by just giving the right side a quick press away from the bag. And I'm doing this on a ham because this is a 3D thing and it's just easier. Now here we have the wrong side. And since it's pre-pressed, it just wants to fold right to the wrong side. See how easy that is? Can you give it a press? And then I like to just put a pin or two in there to keep things in place. You don don't need a ton of pins here. Then you're just going to continue up the handle. And you can see how nicely it just wants to curve to the shape of the handle because we pre-pressed everything. And I'm using plastic head pins. If you're going to get in the way of the pins with your iron, make sure you're using either glass or standard pin. I just use these because it's easy to see where a pin is with these giant pin heads. And then just the other side of the handle. All right, so now we're gonna head back over to our machine, and with the right side facing up, we're going to stitch along the edge of the binding on the binding to anchor the back side in place. And the reason we're stitching on the front is because you wanna make sure that the front looks good. So head over to your machine. Now I am gonna put my edge stitch foot on for this, because I'm stitching over an edge and it will just make my life a lot easier. And our pins are on the wrong side, so you want to make sure you get those out before we hit them. And you don't need a back tack here. Just take it slow, we're not in a race. Going around these curves can be a little messy. Definitely an art to sewing while trying to make sure your fingers aren't blocking the view of the camera. I'm not sure if I've fully mastered it. threads. Big into clipping my threads as I go, that way you don't have a mess when you're done and threads you don't have access to any longer. And look at how nice that looks. Very cute. And then on the back, just check to make sure you caught everything. We did. So that's it for that particular part. Head back over to the table and we'll talk next steps. All right, so both of our inner handles are now bound. So you're gonna fold your bag wrong side out again. We're going to align the top edge of the handles. Pin those in place. Then we're going to head over to our machine and we're going to stitch across here with a half inch seam allowance. Now we need to press those seam allowances open. So a hammer, a sleeve roll will be the easiest way to do that. A sleeve roll would be even easier than a ham, but ham's what I have. So that's what I'm using. Both of our seam allowances are pressed open, so our next step is one by one, fold the handle over so that the seam lines meet. And pin that. Then we're going to go over to our machine and we're going to stitch across here to anchor this in place before we bind the inside neck edge of the bag. So this is going to have a quarter inch seam allowance, so on or just inside of a quarter inch. So once again, you're going to take your handle, you're going to fold so the seam allowance comes together and the two seam lines match, and then we're going to pin the two sides of the handle together. All right, so I am just going to sew just inside of a quarter inch. So again, a quarter inch is the edge of my foot, so just a teeniest bit inside of that. Make sure you get the whole handle because I was just about to miss part of the binding. For the other side. I accidentally activated the knot function. And the reason we're securing these layers together is because it's just a good idea to only have two active layers at a time. And with the binding going around here, that would be three. And if there's nothing securing the center in place, it can kind of move around a little bit. So this is just also making your life easier. So here, this is what it looks like and from the right side. All right, so we now need to cut the binding piece for the center of the bag. So if you are making the small bag with me, you need a 30-inch piece. If you're making the large bag, it's 57 inches. Now what we're gonna do is we need to make a loop. So unfold the bias binding and align the two ends. We're going to align the two ends so the curve of the folds are facing out. And then we're just going to sew right across there at a quarter inch. So head over to your machine and we'll do that now. Now we need to press the seam open. You want to do that without pressing out the folds if you can. And then once you're done, you can press those back in if you like. And then we'll just, there we go. Give it a nice big steam. Now that our bias strip is sewn into a circle, we need to attach it to the neck of the bag. So the easiest way to do that is find the seam where we sewed the circle and use that to find the halfway point. So we're halving the bias strip, and then I'm just going to stick a pin through there. And then I'm also going to find the quarter points. So if you've ever put a neckline in a knit shirt, this is very similar. And this way we're just making sure that everything is evenly distributed around the edge of the bag. Okay, so that is quartered, and now we need to quarter the neck of the bag. So the two tops of the handles are going to be two halfway points, and then we need to find the quarter points here. So to do that, we're just going to align the handle seams and walk the raw edge of the bag until you get the center. And then repeat for the other side. And you don't have to do this, but it's just a few steps that make everything else a lot easier. So now the neck edge of the bag and our binding are now quartered. So we need to pin the binding to the bag. So to do that, I'm going to take the seam of the binding and align it with one of the handle seams. And work around here to make sure you don't pin it twisted. We don't want that to happen. So our quarter point, align there. We'll walk over to our handle. And our final point. All right. So now you might want to stick a pin in here between each of the quarter points, just so things don't shift around while you're sewing. You don't need to, but it can make it a little easier at the machine. Quartering everything also ensures that no part of the bag is gathered into the binding. Just everything's really nice and even this way. All right, so we now have that pinned in place. We're gonna go over to the machine and sew our first line of stitching around the bag. Okay, so at the machine, I have my quarter inch foot on. And I'm going to start up at the handle. I'm gonna sink my needle down into that groove, which again is a quarter inch from the raw edge. And then we're just gonna work our way around the bag. And I am gonna back tack just one or two stitches there because it's over the edge of the binding. Over the seam of the binding, and mine's starting to come undone a tiny bit. So just work around, making sure everything is lined up nicely. And you'll find that the seam line of the binding and the bag align nicely. This edge might need to stretch a tiny bit, or it just might feel like it's not lining up a little bit, but you can see how easy that sews together. Now we're sewing around the deepest point of the curve. So just take it slow. Sometimes the bag can kind of want to move out from under the binding at this point. But we're not in a race, luckily. Pretty sure I would be terrible at competitive sewing. Wow. Back at the other handle. We're sewing through both layers of the handle now. And make sure that's over to the edge. Oops, sorry. And here we have one seam allowance where we bound two pieces of binding together. So just make sure that this seam allowance stays down. I just use a pin to make sure that it goes under correctly. If the seam allowance flips, it's not a huge deal. It just adds a tiny bit more bulk. All right, we are rounding into the other deep curve. So you can see again, the bag is wanting to fight with the binding a tiny bit. So just realign, take it slow. Back up the other handle to where we started. Oh, and you can see I caught that a tiny bit, so I'm just going to raise my needle. Check it out, it's not bad. Just do a back tack. And then you're gonna clip your threads and I'll show you what just happened. So when I was sewing, I was going this way and the seam allowance here wanted to flip over. So I caught it and it's down the right way, but just keep an eye out for that. Now we're gonna head over to the iron. Okay, so that's it for today's lesson. And as I might have mentioned in our video at the beginning, our next lesson will be all about how to make your own bias tape. So if you want help with that, make sure you tune in. And if you purchased your binding, you've got that day off work. I'll see you back here for that lesson. And if you have any questions, just let me know in the comments below. See you later. Bye-bye.